everyone. Welcome to the Art Workshop. I'm your host, Christopher Epling. Thank you so much for tuning in today. We really appreciate you so much. And this is going to be a special show. I say that about every show I know, but this one I really am excited about because for a couple reasons. The first reason is we get to actually work using a technique that I absolutely love, and I work in this technique all the time. Second is we're going to be drawing one of my favorite characters from popular mainstream pop culture. So this is a cool show. I really hope you're excited about it. So I guess we should probably get started so you know what we're doing. Now, my background is in illustration and comics. That's my main background. I work professionally as an illustrator. I draw comics. I love creating pen and ink drawings. That's my favorite, absolute favorite medium to work in. So today I thought about tying that in to something here because we like to relate it to our area. Being here from Eastern Kentucky, we like to talk about how these things relate. So I was thinking about how do I relate this character we're going to be drawing to our area. Then it hit me, well, absolutely, we have many forests surrounding us. Forest for as far as the eye can see in central Appalachia. And talk a little bit about trees now for a minute. All Kentuckians benefit from our trees and our forest. You know, whether it's like a dense stand of hardwoods in the eastern part here in eastern Kentucky or this riparian forest along the rivers in the west or even like stately bur oak in the bluegrass, every Kentuckian breathes clean air and drinks clean water and enjoys the wildlife and even uses products that are derived from our trees. And you know, although the Division of Forestry serves landowners and communities and all Kentuckians, you know, they also ask that by maintaining the health and productivity of our forests, it's important that, you know, all citizens of our state, you know, recognize the resource in order for we can ensure sustainability and have trees and forests growing in the future. And all these things add to the beauty also of our region. So now, tying this into a character, we're going to be talking about a technique today. And the technique that we use, and we're going to be using in art, is called cross-hatching. Now, cross-hatching is a term that's used in art really just to represent in drawing graphics, you shade an area or you darken in an area using intersecting sets of parallel lines. That's the definition of cross-hatching. So cross-hatching is going to be the technique, and our subject today, what we're going to be drawing, is a popular character from Marvel, Guardians of the Galaxy, Groot. Now, some of you at home, I know, I don't want to lose you. You may say, Groot, what is Groot? And I know what a root is. What's a Groot? Well, it's a character, and the character's a tree. But the character moves around, has, you know, acts as just like a person with arms and legs. It can grow back limbs if needed. It's a tree. So bear with me. The cool thing about Groot, if you don't know who Groot is that there's many, many really cool opportunities when drawing Groot to use this technique of cross-hatching. And that's what we're going to be doing. So I'm going to show you today the subject that we're looking at. I've got an image here ready to go. So get your pen and pencil ready. Get some an ink pen as well and an eraser. And let's get started on today's art workshop. All right, so this is the character Groot. As you can see, Groot is coming up, growing from a pot. He's a tree. He's a small plant. He gets really big. Then he becomes a more mature adult Groot with legs. But in this baby form, this is a baby Groot, he's growing still. So you can see he hasn't grown the legs yet. It's getting bigger. So we're going to be drawing this today together. Now what we're going to do, we're going to leave this off to the side because we want to be able to see it as we move along. I want you to be able to see it somewhat here. But more importantly, I want you to have your paper ready because we're going to draw this. Now we're going to start out on the head here. This is where we're starting out. Okay, and what I want you to do at home is I want you to draw a circle, okay? Just draw a circle, just like that, on a piece of paper, okay? All right, you should have a circle drawn. Now, what this circle is going to help us to do is to create this roundness here of the head. So we're going to work on this area first, okay? So coming up from the edge of your circle over here, I want you to draw a line. Now, look, we're going to make all these little twigs coming up representing these limbs representing his hair, okay? So you're going to draw a line coming up stopping and coming down. Now, arrows will not look exactly like this one. We're gonna come up with something pretty close. Now, you see how I've drawn this little tip? It looks like a horn. You're gonna continue doing that. I'm gonna add some more of these coming off the top of your circle. You can see how this is working. We're just coming down and back up again, making all these little types of shapes coming off of the head, okay? And this is important because these little shapes are going to represent Groot's hair, and it also helps us in understanding where we are in terms of the drawing and what we have left to do, right? So keep going, making these little shapes, all these coming off the top of the circle. As you can see, we're just making these little lines up, back down. And once you get to the edge of your circle, once you've drawn, it looks like all these, looks like fire almost. You've drawn all these little shapes off the top of your circle. You're gonna come down, follow the line that you created for your circle. Now what we're doing is just adding more definition to the shape of the face, okay? So you can see now what I've done. Notice the line that goes all the way around the bottom of the chin here. This is the line we've just drawn, down and around. So you see this shape of the circle at the top now? We can get rid of that. So go ahead and erase that. We don't need it anymore. We've drawn the shape of the head, and now we really don't need it anymore. So you can get rid of it. And now you can see a little better what we've done. We've got this shape that makes up Groot's head, okay? Now let's go ahead and focus a little more on the head, staying in this area. Let's go ahead and draw these two circles for the eyes, okay? So I'm going to place one here. Now notice where I'm placing my circles. You have to look at the subject we're looking at and then look at the drawing. The eyes, the face, is offset a little bit. Let me show you what I mean by that. If you drew a line down the middle of this drawing right here, okay, you can see that you can see more of this side of the head than you can this side of the head because the face is turned just slightly. While drawing air character, we have to do that as well. So we're gonna draw a circle there, and we're gonna put another circle right over here. So you can see how that works. So you have two circles. They're off to the right just a little bit. They're not dead center, okay? And just like with their character reference picture, we can draw this line, a little tiny line. We're going to erase this in a second. Going down between the eyes. That helps to show us where the mouth should be. So now let's go ahead and add Groot's smile, right? So he's smiling. He's happy. We come over here to this side, and we got it. So there we go. So now we have two eyes and a mouth on our Groot. Now notice at the top what we're looking at in this reference. Above the circles, you have these little lines that come up like this, okay? They're really small lines, but the eyes, if you could see this character in real life, what happens is the eyes are actually sort of inserted into the wood a little bit. It's not like setting on top of the head. They're inside of the wood. So we need to be sure and show these little lines, and what this does is it helps us to give the impression that the eyes are inside of the wood, okay? They're not resting on top, and that's important. So just a couple little lines right around the eyes. Now, the eyes are gonna be shaded in completely black. However, we're gonna put a couple little circles. Now these little circles, if you know anything about cartooning, represents eye shine. So this is where the light is being reflected. So when we go in a little while and ink this, we want to be sure and leave these little areas here where the light is actually being reflected, just like that. Now we're almost done actually with the head besides adding more details and such. But before we do that, let's pay attention to something. On this reference picture, we see these other areas behind what we've drawn that are solid. They're completely black. So we want to add more of these little shapes coming up in behind what we've drawn already. See what I'm doing? I'm adding more of these. But what I'm doing is I'm making sure here at the end when we're finished, these are going to be solid black. They're going to be subdued. They're going to be, you can't see them very well. This helps us to see that Groot's head is actually rounded and these little limbs of wood that represent hair are coming off of the head in all sorts of directions and all sorts of angles and things. So we want to be sure and show that. So now I've added those in. All these will be darkened in later. So these will actually be black. If it helps you some, I can shade this in so you can see what I've done. Okay? All this will be darkened in later. This will be solid black. This gives the impression that the head is rounded at the top, that his head is not just 2D, it's just not just one shape, a flat surface, that it's actually rounded just by adding these little subdued blackened in lines coming out from behind it. So just by adding that, we're going to get the effect that his head is rounded. So you can see what I've done there now, okay? All right, so now let's focus on the body. Now look at the body. We have all these lines coming down and they're wrapping around. The first thing we want to do though is we want to draw the general shape of what this looks like. So I'm just going to draw this line coming down. See how it curves? It comes down, curves in, and curves out. Okay? We'll do the same thing over here. Line comes down, curves out. This time curves back in. We have the general shape now of the body. So let's go in now and add all these little details. What we're going to do is we're going to start at the top and we're going to start drawing lines coming down the body. Okay, I've drawn two lines coming down and back up. These are actually roots, and if you could see this a little easier, a little closer up, this could be seen a little bit more easily. You could see that all these little lines wrap around one another, like you took a rope and you twisted it, right? So that's what's happening. All these little lines are actually wrapping around one another, and we want to be sure and get that effect in our drawing. We want the effect that the lines are twisting. This is a root, okay? And these roots are twisting about, making up Groot's body. How you make that effect is by drawing all these little lines, okay, over and over, and you want to show them twisting. So you're going to draw lines that are sort of going over top of the other lines and things of that nature. You keep doing this. You keep adding tons of these little lines everywhere you can see in all directions leading up to the body. Once you've done that, you could put a little more detail in. So you see, you notice down here at the bottom, there's this little twig sticking out here. So we can add that. You put all this little detail in at the very end. So don't worry about it too much right now, okay? We're just going to draw this one to show you what I mean. See little details like that. We're going to worry about that in a minute. But first, we're focusing just on the general shape. Let's go back up now to the arms. Notice how the arms are sticking out. So on each side, you're going to draw these lines coming down. Just draw the general shape of the arm first, out to the hand, the wrist, down to the elbow, to the body. You're going to draw these general shapes first. Then you're going to start adding all these little lines coming down. Now, this isn't cross-hatching, okay? This is just basic drawing. When cross-hatching comes into play in a little bit, you're going to see how we can really make all these lines look as if they're twisted over one another and tangled up. Now the hand is something a little more abstract because it doesn't really look like fingers. So what I like to do is draw an oval, okay? So you'll draw this oval at the tip of your arm just like that. Once you have that oval, start adding things like the thumb comes down, sort of sticks out like that. Now this isn't supposed to look representational of a hand, like a human's hand. You're supposed to be able to see fingers. You're supposed to be able to tell that's a hand, but we want to leave it sort of abstract so you can't really tell, okay? Something like that. So you just draw these little lines coming down from your ovals representing the fingers. Do the same thing with over on this side. We're going to bring this arm out to the elbow. We're going to bring it up to the wrist. Just like this. Now we have the general shape. Once we have the general shape, we're good to go because we can go back in and we can add all this detail. This is where all the little detail starts to matter, is because these little lines coming down the arm of Groot actually twist about just like the body, forming his arm. Okay? You got to think about it in terms of roots and things that grow. Let's go ahead and add the oval up here at the top for his hand, just like that. Once we have that, we can start putting our detail in. So for the thumb, and then here's a finger that's coming out. Well, it's supposed to be a finger. And something else that looks like a finger sticking down, and one more. So now we have this series of lines that kind of look like a hand on this side. Now we've got the basic shape and some of the features of Groot so far compared to our example. What we need to include now at the bottom is the pot that Groot sets in. How you do that is you start at the edge, figure out how wide do you want your pot. You go draw this line that comes all the way around, and then once you figure out how big your pot's going to be, you bring it back in, just like that. So it kind of looks like the letter C if you were to take it and flip it on its side and look at it. I know it's kind of a difficult analogy, but it is what it is. It really does look like that. So we're going to continue now around the back side of the pot. Now we have the rim of the pot right here. Inside of that, here where all the roots and things are, we want to add more of these little lines. All these little lines are going to come into play later because they're going to make up the image and all the detail. Now, over on the side, bring this line down. Now, really, you have to decide how big of a pot you want him to set in. This is a pretty big pot here. And bring it down. Mine's going to be about that big. Okay, I think that's probably good. And also, you have to pay attention to the angle from which you're drawing these lines, because if you draw the angle off a little bit, your pot's going to look crooked, okay? And no one wants a crooked pot. Here we go. Bring this out now. Shape it up a little more. And we can shape this up a little bit more just in a little bit. Now, notice here there's a little twig that's coming down and hanging off of the pot here. So this comes up just a little bit, down, and it curls at the end. This is where we go back in now and add a little more detail to everything, such as up here around the head. Okay, we want the head to be shaped more square than a circle, even though we started out with that circle. That circle is just there to help guide us. It's not there to tell us exactly where to go. Now, on Groot's head, we're going to put some of these little series of lines, and we're going to start putting in the detail now. Okay, this is where things get really fun. This is where cross-hatching comes in. So once we have all the little details put in where we think we want them, we go back now with our pen, and we're going to start to put in all the super details in. We're going to really get in there and really make this stand out. So grab a pen. It doesn't matter if it's a felt tip pen or if it's a ink pen, a ballpoint pen. Anything will work. It doesn't matter. Have that ready, because now we're going to actually go in and we're going to start adding all the cross hatching. This is the fun part for me. I love cross hatching. So I'm going to use a felt pen. This is a size small, so I like to test it out over here on the side. That's about right. Now you're going to trace over all the outside lines. Don't worry about cross hatching just yet. You're just going to, all you're doing right now is tracing over all the lines that you want to keep. Because what's going to happen is, at the end of this drawing, we are actually going to take our eraser and we're going to erase all of the pencil lines, okay? And get rid of all those pencil lines. So see what I'm doing? I'm going back now and I'm tracing over all the major lines I want to keep. This does not have anything to do with cross-hatching just yet. Cross-hatching will come very soon after you get all your lines traced. That's when you can actually start your cross hatching, okay? So spare with me, and you do this, follow me along at home. You can do this too. You want to make sure your drawing looks nice and clean with all these little lines you're making. Tracing over everything you did. Cross hatching can be really time constraining, so we're going to have to probably go ahead, and we're going to speed draw through me doing the outline, because I really want to get to the point where we're cross hatching, okay? So you follow me at home and just be sure and trace all the lines you've drawn just right now as of yet, and then we'll pick back up here just in a second, okay? So let's go ahead and outline our drawing. So outlining is important. We talk about that a lot no matter what we're focusing on, because with the outline, we're then able to go back in and put all that really wonderful detail. Now when it comes to pins, and especially when we're doing a character as complex as what we're doing today, it's a good idea to have a variety of tips. Now, I'm going to show you what I mean by that. So the pen that I used here to outline our drawing is what's called a medium, which is probably about a 0.2. Now what that means is pens come in different sizes for the tips. So some are 1, 2, 3, 4. As you go larger, the pen size gets bigger, okay? I have a couple of different options today. Now what I've brought with me are two pens. Now this is different brands, so their sizes is small and medium. This is probably about a 0.2 and this is about a 0.3, okay? We used the 0.2 to outline our character. I also brought a brush pen. Now the brush pen is really there to give all that real thick detail like that, okay? Brush pen, which is a felt brush. I've also brought a synthetic brush pen, which is a little more controllable in terms of adding detail. And then the last thing I've brought is this fountain pen, which is really small and thin. You can see by the line, if you can even see that line, it's very small. So the first thing that I'm going to do, though, with this character is I'm going back in with my brush pen. If you don't have a brush pen at home, it's okay, but what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to actually color in with whatever you have. And it may be a little more time-consuming, but you can get it done. If you're really dedicated to it, you can. I'm going first up here to this area. Do you remember this area we talked about earlier where I said if we were to put these little shapes in behind the hair, it'll look like the head is more rounded? Well, that's the first area I'm going for. And all I'm doing is I'm using my brush and I'm coloring in this area, making it darker so that it looks as if it's behind the other shapes. By doing so, again, it adds a little bit of a depth perception to your drawing. It makes it look as though it's a little more 3D, not so 2D. 2D meaning flat. 3D meaning, you know, it's more, has more rounded shapes. It's more, in real world, it's more dimensions to it. There's a, you know, there's space involved. There's depth involved. There's all those things. That's what we want. We want it to look that way. As closest to the original subject drawing, which is over here, as we can get. And of course, we can't do a drawing exactly like whatever it is we're looking at, but we could try to come pretty close. We can do our own interpretation. Of course, the eyes, remember I talked about leaving that white in there for the shine? So we definitely want to leave that in there. That's important. And once we get this all inked over, we can go back in and add our crosshatching, which is the whole point of really why we're doing this. Now, the crosshatching is something that takes a lot of time, okay? So we're going to do portions of it together. If we start running out of time, what we can do is actually speed it up a little bit, but I really want to cover this with you on how to do this properly, because so many times artists I've seen, and I've had to learn this too, I wasn't born knowing these things, of course not, and there's things that I learn now continuously. I learn from other artists, watching other artists draw. That's one of the most helpful things to me anyway, is actually watching another artist draw something. When I do that, I'm able to see how did they go about creating that look? How did they get that effect? So now we've put the eyes in. Now notice, keep going back to your subject drawing, and notice the areas that are very dark. Directly underneath the chin of Groot, we have a lot of black. So we're going to put that in now. All right, this is supposed to give the effect that his head is on top of the structure below it. It's not like the head is like just hanging out there in the middle of nowhere, right? And we want this effect to look. Now, we're not coloring it all. We're leaving some of this area because we want it also, a little bit later, to give that effect of this is rounded. You know, these shapes are actually moving down into something below it here. So keep on working with your pen. I know if you don't have a brush pen, you can figure out how to do this with a ballpoint pen just the same. Again, it will take longer to do, but shading is really, really an important part of comics and all art. And
We've done some shows on shading, but maybe in the future we can do something more in depth where we're actually shading in something using all brush pens. That'd be a fun show to do later on, I think. So here we go. We're just adding a lot of black. We're trying to get this to look as close to over here as we can. Notice at the bottom, inside of the actual pot, back here, this part is all black. So we want to make sure and color that in and bring it out to tips, just like this. So I'm not coloring it out outright. I'm going all the way. I'm not outright coloring it all in. I'm going all the way with these little strokes, okay? So I'm not doing it completely black. It's not all the way black. It's small strokes. Now, some areas are, of course, darkened in more than others, but we want the effect that this bowl or this pot is rounded. We don't want the effect that he's just sitting on top of something flat, okay? And this is how we get that effect. We add a lot of shading, and we continue to add shading to it. Cross-hatching now comes into play where we have this drawing, okay? But we need to go back in now and give the effect that the roots, okay, all these little tiny lines are roots, that these roots are actually, you know, intertwined with one another. They're not just floating out in the middle of nowhere. So we're going to grab our pen in a second after I finish up a little more detail with this black brush, and we're going to work on our cross-hatching. Now, cross-hatching is a very old form of comics creating. Now, a lot of times you may see full, when it comes to a shadow, you may see a solid color. But cross-hatching is an old-school way of going about it. And I'm going to use this very, very, very thin pen. It's a very small tip on this pen. I'm starting at the top, and what I'm going to do is make these little lines ever so often, as you can see, and it's going to add that detail in there, right? That's what we want. We want the detail. And I'm just going around it and around it, and I keep adding to it, and I'm making small parallel lines. See the little parallel lines? You follow the same shape as whatever it is that you've drawn, the outline you've drawn. You follow that shape, okay? And you're going to go all around making these tiny little lines. As you draw with these lines, you get thinner and thinner with your line. Now, what I mean by that is, and I'll draw it on a separate sheet so you can see real fast, okay? So, with cross-hatching, you go, let's say this is the line of something here, okay? This is one of those tips up there at the hair, okay? Just imagine that's one of these strands of hair up here. So you would take your pencil, your pen, and you're going to make lines going following the shape. And look how this gets smaller as you go down. See that? So you're following the shape that you've drawn. And as you get closer to where you're stopping, you make smaller, thinner lines. Okay? Now the idea is once you do this, you're going to go back then, okay, and you're going to cross over top of them like this. Like you're making X's, all kinds of X's. All the way down. Now you see how that looks now like a shadow. So all it is lines, parallel lines, intersecting one another. That's what we're doing. It's nothing major. It's not really anything too complicated, but it might be a little hard for you to see it though on the camera. I'm going to use a thicker tip now, so maybe you can see it a little better. This is the important part. See these shapes going down the body here? You want to make all these little parallel lines going down, following the shape, just like I showed you over here. You follow your line, getting thinner as you go down, closer to where you're stopping, okay? Now, what these lines help us to do with our drawings, it makes it look as if these little roots down through here have shape to them. They're not just open white areas where nothing's being darkened in. This is a root that has marks showing that it's rounded, okay? It has these parallel lines showing that it's actually moving towards something. It's flowing down. It's not just stasis or stationary. It's not stagnant. It's moving in a way, although it's standing still. It's has a shape to it. And we want to respect that shape. We want to try to get as close as we can to looking as if, though, you know, we're representing a real thing here, even though this is a cartoon character. You know, even though this is something made up, it doesn't exist in reality. But we can follow the same rules that, you know, fine artists work with, such as shading and hues and color balance and all these things when it comes to comics. We're not limited just to a few different tools in our toolbox. We have all the tools that a fine artist has in creating their piece. Now, down back at the pot, at the below here, I want you to see what I've done. Over here, where the pot comes around to the edge, I've darkened in the corners here and here, and then I've went behind Groot and I've colored in the pot here. So what this does is it gives the effect that this has got some space inside it, like you could stick more stuff down in the pot, right? But what this artist has chosen to do, and I think this is interesting, they've added these little lines on their pot to look like it's not just a clean, pretty, brand new pot. There's scratches involved. This pot's been moved around, transported back and forth. So what you do as a final thing is add a few little lines. It doesn't matter where, just add a little character to the pot, right? And make it look as if, you know, it's been through a little bit of something. It's not just a brand new pot it's setting in. So Groot is a fun character. It's a very fun character to draw. You have all these lines that intersect and intertwine. It's just really, really fun to get in and creating something from scratch. Always, always sign your work. Now, if you followed along with me at home today and you created your own Groot and you'd like to share that here on the Art Workshop, we would love to show it. All you have to do is email that to me, and it's at eplingillustrations@gmail.com. Send me the image, and I will share it here with all of our viewing audience, your amazing work that you created there at home. Even if you didn't follow along, let's say there's a certain type of style of art that you like to draw in a lot. Maybe it's something we haven't covered a lot in this workshop, which is manga. So let's say you like that style of art and you want to share it. Please, we'd love to see it. In the future, we're even thinking about, and probably will, going to bring on other artists. So we're going to be learning about new styles and techniques. And the fun part about it, I've been sharing my work with you for so long. Here in the future, what's going to be cool is we're going to bring other artists in, and I'm going to learn from them. So I'm going to learn along with you. And we together will do something for the first time. Because I know throughout the process of the workshop, you've had to do a lot on your own with me teaching you. So it'll be kind of cool to see that in reverse coming up. So thank you so much for participating. I really hope you've had a great time. I hope everything has been enjoyable. I hope you've not got stressed out too much over all the cross-hatching. Please send me your work. I'd love to see it. And until next time, you don't know how much we appreciate you tuning in. And I'm Christopher Epling, and keep drawing.